Hi, today I'm going to talk about a phonemic awareness skill called sound substitution. Today we're going to talk about the initial sound substitution of a word or the first sound in a word. So the only material you need is your arm. And so this is kind of how I talk to my kids about our sounds. So we might use just basic consonant, vowel, consonant words. And so the beginning, my shoulder is the beginning sound, my elbow is my middle sound, and then my hand is my ending sound. So I might say, for example, this is the word cat, right? I'm gonna model it for them and then I'm gonna have them repeat the motion with me. So they'll be using their arms as well and their other hand to point out the beginning, the middle, and the ending sounds. So if I said, Mrs. Lucero's saying the word cat. Now you show me the word cat. And they would say cat. Remember, you start at your shoulder because this is where the beginning sound is. So we're going to say it again. Watch Mrs. Lucero. Cat. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back up here to my beginning sound for cat. I'm going to take off the k sound. I'm going to get rid of it. And I'm going to put the b sound right here. Now I'm going to have a new word. So now my word is bat. Do you guys see that? Here's my word, cat. I take off the beginning sound. I put a new sound, b, and it changes my word from cat to bat. So what I do is I have the kids model that with me. I usually only spend maybe 3 or 4 minutes on the activity, but I'll do it every day. And so I'll say, and so once we get a little more fluent, I'll say, say the word cat, and they'll say cat. Take off the k, put a b, what do you have? And they should say bat. And they are also doing the same motion with me while I'm doing it. So I'll say, say cat, and they'll do this motion. I'll say, take off the k, they take off the k motion, put a b, they put the b sound, and then read the word bat. And so you can do this with any consonant, vowel, consonant word. So I can do pan. Say the word pan, pan. Take off the p sound, put a f sound. What word do you have now? Fan. So we're wanting them to distinguish the beginning sound and connect it with the final two sounds to make a new word. And that's how I do sound substitution with my kindergartners and pre-K kids. Thanks.